would be more like two co-workers spending a little quality time together. We'll build a bar right here in Superjail. It'll be the perfect spot for a rendezvous.
Sir, I am a recovering alcoholic.
Great! Then you can be the bartender. Let's get to work.
You couldn't even get your inmates to act civilized for even one night.
I'll take your bait. Let's have a grand ball, and whosoever inmates act the most civilized will be the winner. I win your ladies, or you win my super jail. Each of these lucky inmates will become mini-inmates, shrunken with my awesome micro-technology, so they can battle the forces of nature and test their will to survive inside my terrarium! Oh, Jared, how can that enormous head of yours be so full of such tiny ideas? Obviously, we just need to make Superjail bigger! Oh, who is that? I have to meet her. Maybe Uber Jail or Wundo Prison. Well, it's their loss. She's our little Wonder Guard now, isn't she?
I'm sorry, guys. I tried to stop.
Hello, young lovers. Just thought I'd pop in and give my blessings on your special day. Ta-da! And then you exchange the rings. Simple. Now you give it a whirl. My goodness, Alice. We've ruined the purest thing in Superjail. Love. The powerful love born of convenience and limited options. And what better symbol of marital bliss than forced confinement? After all, true love is inescapable. Jared, stick with me here. I'm on a roll. As I was saying, love smothers, contains, imprisons man's baser instincts to run wild and free. And if Cupid is an enemy of freedom, then by golly, he is a friend of Superjail. Gee, I don't know. It's so flat, so gray. Where's the style? The color, the curves and wiggles, the kinks and dinks and spindling dead ends. Oh, now you've got me all tense. Jailbot 2.0, commence vibrate mode. Only now have I learned that there's a little bit of poor Timmy inside us all.
You certainly weren't this receptive when I went through my 12 steps.
Yeah, that was kind of a bummer. But this, I had no idea addiction could be so sensational and cinematic. Why, any one of us could be weed-whacked at any moment. Have we got proof that Alice is tripping the light fantastic?
Well, I'm stumped. And if I've never heard of it, it must be some vile...
So Alice really is corrupt? Oh, God, what do we do?
Well, we could, smoke it.
That's brilliant.
What?
Think about it. We're the respected authority figures. If they see the man strung out on drugs, it won't be cool anymore. And Alice and the inmates will reform.
Sir, that's...
Genius! What the hell, huh?
Hell? Oh, no. You flatter me. This is merely super jail. I am the warden, jailer slash raising enthusiast, and you've got a job to do. Look, I need a ringer to win this. You've got glory and acclaim to spare. All I want is to borrow some. If you win the race in my guise, I'll have my victory, and you'll be allowed to go free.
Allowed?
No, Jared. We have to help them.
What? But they're traitors!
Sure, they're treacherous mutineers, but when those twisted, broken souls pass through the gates of Superjail, I made a sacred promise to help them. We're going down there, and we're going to save them. And by golly, we're going to finish this cruise and give them the best vacation of their life.
Aye, aye, Captain.
There. That's where I want the new petting zoo. Now, should I list the animals by name, rarity, or hostility towards human contact? Because I've got it memorized each way.
Sir, don't you think the inmates would benefit from something more practical? A computer lab would...
be totally boring. This is super jail, not super detention, Jared. I've never let an inmate die of boredom, and I won't start now just because you think like a failure.
Sir, failure is an awfully harsh word.
Hey, don't beat yourself up. Sure, super jail would suck if we did things your way. But that's why I'm here, to protect you from being an uninspired, short-sighted, small-thinking failure. Now, as for that petting zoo.
Magic is an art form that takes practice, hard work, and discipline.
I don't have the time or the patience for patience and hard work. Mark my words, amazing Jared. I'll find a way to be the most talented employee in Superjail.
Grape juice?
Never been much of a drinker.
Oh, sir, can you ever forgive me?
Fame can change a man, Jared. Give him a big head, and your head is already big. Enormous, actually. The cards were stacked against you from the start, I guess. I forgive you, Jared.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Oh, Jared, we did do it. Paul is reformed.
What?
We took a hardened criminal and instilled the virtues of loyalty, turned this weak individual into someone who leads by example. Now he's a man who's worthy of this thing you call parole. Take him and integrate him back into the regular world so he may take my lessons of reformation and share them with the masses.
But, sir, Paul has enough new violations to keep him here at Superjail another 50 years.
I know. Oh, isn't it great? Games that indulge the senses and soothe the soul. Perhaps Superjail's entire populace could reap the benefits were I to somehow make this gaming experience one of multiple players. Try this.
Wow, that's delicious.
I know, it's like my taste buds have been awakened from a long winter slumber. Save some for the rest of us, chubbo. What's the next event on my calendar? We need an excuse for a feast.
Well, there's nothing on the docket except for the yearly electric chair.
Perfect. We'll have a 7-course last meal of last meals. Send someone out with a real bang.
Sir, it's just a test.
Oh, Jared, there you go again, worrying about the details. You should worry about the sweet deliciousness of flavor that will be creamily rolling down your throat and soaking into your bloodstream. But if you don't want to be invited to my dinner party.
No, I do. Let's fry someone.
I hear you're the woman who's been making my gastric juices go gaga.
Beat it. I don't have time for food groupies.
They say the way to a man's heart is through his stomach.
Gross.
No! Why are we restraining this man? Let him go! This is Superjail, man! We're life-affirming! Speaking of life-affirming, where's our culinary queen? Let's get out of here! Mmm, delicious!
Ugh. I am stuffed. I can't wait to see what's for breakfast.
I quit.
We'll teach that weirdress a thing or two about responsibility. Once we identify your papa, you little bundle of criminal instincts, you'll get the paternal bonding you need to overcome your murderous tendencies and achieve everything you want in life. It's called playing God for a reason, Doctor. Let's have some fun.
Sir, I'm not sure the clones will sit through your parenting lecture.
We can't snuff out the pick of the litter without a little child-rearing 101.
Shouldn't you have changed the real baby? Sir, this is a disaster! They're destroying each other and Superjail!
It's called natural selection, Jared. Survival of the fittest. They're instinctively competing for the honor of fatherhood. And to stand in their way is to deny the will of Papa Nature. Pish posh! This sweet silence clearly means the clones are off contemplating the colossal opportunity of raising their own. You've done it! You've conquered the competition and claimed this cuddly would-be con as your own. No prisoner of mine is gonna miss some cowardly voice on a staticky old radio.
I won't. I mean, they won't.
Nope, because I'm going to give them 3,000 channels of Super TV!
I don't remember us greenlighting some of these other series.
TV isn't rocket science, it's brain candy. All you have to do is trust your gut.
Well, whatever you're doing, it's working.
Shh, it's time for Jail Pup.
Sir!
Green light, I love mimes. Jared, let's give these two artistes their own variety hour.
Sir!
Plague! Oh, my dear sweet necrotized Alice. Jared, where is Planet Radio? I want these fetid vermin obliterated from my universe!
I'm sorry, sir.
A good day, gentlemen. I couldn't help but overhear your disagreement, and let me say that there's plenty of room in this prison for all homemade and manufactured weapons. There I was, thinking respect was missing from this institution, and here you show up like some hideously disfigured little angel to remind me that all is not lost. Yes, as long as they see smoke, this mob's flame lust will be satisfied.
But sir!
Don't be so selfish, Jared. Besides, it'll be just a small controlled blaze. From here on out, this is a smoke-free facility! Sorry, Alice, but the rules of a full life expectancy are the same for everyone! Fresh air in your lungs! Now, doesn't that feel good?
You're a douche.
No smokers loitering in my yard, cowering in my doorways, polluting my lungs, stealing company time, sneaking their fixes throughout this hallowed utopia we call Superjail. Together, we will get this monkey off your backs once and for all. Nice work, Alice. I wish some others cared as much as you. This wouldn't have happened if you'd been on the ball, mister. I want you guarding this place 24-7. No intruders, zero tolerance, and you'll do it by yourself. We'll gossip later, Jared. A little busy rebuilding a water wheel, unless you know a better way to make rivers run. Your chance to witness the awesomeness of Manglefang. Come on, you'll love him. Now admit that he's real, and only then will you get to be as righteous and as well-balanced as I am. Can't you guys see I'm doing this for you? So just admit he's real and you love him, and we all believe the same thing. So says the Superjail Inquisitor. Look, buddy, just get on board and everything will be cool, all right?
No!
Stop moping. It's time for my big race.
Our big race. Give me your leg.
Ooh, sorry. Did you not get the memo? I'm in it to win it this year. And I have a feeling that me and my new partner here are going to blow away the competition.
Whatever.
His head is bigger than mine? That's a direct violation of the Superjail Constitution. Wait till I get my hands on him. Follow my lead. I did it! I wear the pants in this universe. A yoo-hoo! Ahem, oh fellas! Come out, wherever you are! Hope you brought your galoshes. I can keep this up all day. Huh.